Per special request, me electrocuting a pickle. So to begin, I ohmed out my pickle because I wanted to use Ohm's Law to figure out how many amps it was going to draw, and it told me it was like 1.2 million, which I thought was crazy high. So I moved my meter leads into this position and got 35,000. This should equate to about 0.003 amps, which I think is low. And here's my power supply, which is just a tinned up extension cord. So let's plug it in and see what happens. It was at this moment that I realized I didn't have a fire extinguisher that was rated for pickle. However, I am a professional and I trusted that everything was going to be safe. What I found to be interesting was right in the beginning, it was pulling an amp draw of right around 0.8 amps, which means my pickle should have had a resistance of around 150 ohms if we're using Ohm's Law. And to do that, you take the voltage divided by the resistance value, and that gives you the amp draw. What ended up happening was after current was flowing for more than just a couple of seconds, the amp draw actually started to go down by more than just a little bit. And I think this had something to do with the arcing creating carbon, which would have created more resistance, thus lowering my amp draw. Now at this point, I'm totally just playing with my pickle trying to get that amp draw. And there's gonna be my meeting with HR on Monday. Trying to get that amp draw to actually increase. I was surprised at how little current I was actually able to get flowing through the pickle. And what I tried to do was move my cord closer and closer towards the other end of the cord to see if by reducing the amount of pickle I went through, I could increase the amp draw. And it worked a little bit, but not as well as I wanted. And I didn't want to get any closer because if I touch the two wires together, I'm going to dead short it and pop a breaker. So I fully admit this was kind of a fun video to do. I just want to point out that I know I'm handling this wire and it may seem dangerous, and I'm not going to say that it's not dangerous. However, I am actually a professional and this was done in a controlled environment. However, I don't necessarily recommend that this is something that you should try on your own if you're not comfortable in handling electricity. And by handling it, I mean using it, not actually handling it.